Hello watch fans, it's Anders here on Watch On channel. Today I'm very fortunate to introduce you to a brand new and very cool historical watch from AVI-8 watches. I am actually wearing a watch from the sister company to AVI-8. This is Spinnaker, and Spinnaker are specializing in dive watches, in water-related watches. If you're interested in aviation and the air, the sky, then you look into AVI-8 watches because they're all about pilot watches and the history of World War I and World War II. So let's get into the watch. It comes in this kind of cardboard box with a fabric on the outside of the box. Pretty neat packaging for this watch. This watch was sent to me from AVI-8 watches. Thank you a lot to AVI-8 watches for sending in this watch for review. I get to keep the watch. So that's why I also noted this video as a kind of a sponsored video. I think there's actually two things about this watch which are especially interesting. It's the history of the watch, and then it's the design of the watch. It really did a big job of making a tribute to a war hero from especially World War II, but he was also involved in World War I. But the other thing is the design aspect, and we will of course also be looking at the technical features and how accurate this watch is. This is a new edition of the P-51 Mustang, which is named after the famous British warplane in World War II, the P-51 Mustang. This is the P-51 Mustang Hitchcock, and this is because it was actually named after a historical figure, an American called Tommy Hitchcock Jr. So this guy, he was actually, when he was just 17 years of age, he was actually volunteering to test planes, fighter planes during World War I. During World War II, he was actually outstationed in London as a diplomat, and he got involved in the P-51 Mustang from the British Royal Air Force. And he actually got deep involved with this airplane and actually helped develop this plane to become a very, very efficient and dangerous plane. And this actually helped the Allies to gain air supremacy and actually also helped to turn the war. The watch, as you can see on the backside here, is actually called, as you can see here, 10 Gold Tommy. And that's actually a nickname for Tommy, the Tommy Hitchcock Jr. person, because he actually also played cricket, and his handicap was 10. So this is a tribute to this historical figure. This watch is definitely all about the dial. So you can see you get this kind of grainy or kind of worn out texture to the main dial. Then you get the numbers, but they actually mix between minutes and hours. So you get 0, then you get 5, 2, 20, 0, 5, no 6, 0, 7, 40 at 8, no 9, 10, and then you get 55. You can maybe just sense it here. And then you get this plate here between 12 and 3 with AVI-8, and they actually cut in, so it's a sandwich style, as you can see. When we get closer here, it's a sandwich style. So a lot of things is happening with this watch. At 6 o'clock, you have the date, and I really enjoy the fact that they made the inverted colors with the white on black. And then you get the blue accents of the cool second hand and automatic above 3 o'clock. Here they actually write the beat rate. This is a Seiko NH35A movement. It has a beat rate of 21,600 vibrations per hour. And it's a very tried and tested movement. AVI-8 and also their sister brand Spinnaker, they use a lot of NH35A movement. So tried and tested automatic movement with 41 hours of power reserve. I tested this in various positions, and I get between plus 3 and plus 15 seconds per day. So it's definitely acceptable. Looking at the loom, we get some nice loom here, Swiss Super Luminova. You see, you don't get loom all the way around. And an interesting fact is that you get the loom at 10 o'clock because this is named 10 Gold Tommy. So of course 10 is very pronounced. It is a dial with a lot of depth and a lot of texture and features, and I really think they made a great job of designing this watch. Very fun, kind of Panerai inspired, because you also get this guard here for the crown. It's very easy to pull out the crown and operate the watch, so absolutely no problem. You get 50 meters of water resistance, sapphire crystal, as you can see here. The anti-reflective coating isn't the best. The case and the bezel is very nicely grayish black glossy treated to give this kind of stealth look. One of the things that is very impressive to me, and which also impressed me when I reviewed the other version of this watch, is definitely the leather strap. Top quality gray leather strap, nice thickness, nice texture to it. Also matching AVI-8 buckle here. Very nice underneath. And here we have the see-through case back where you can see the 10 gold tummy and you can see the customary AVI-8 rotor with the 8 for 8 for AVI-8. AVI-8 stayed 43, but I closer to 44 because you have this big crown guard, but it wears smaller. 14.4 millimeters in thickness, lock width of 22, and almost 51 millimeters lock tip to lock tip. On my 18 centimeter wrist circumference, you can see the P-51 Mustang 10 gold tummy wears really nicely on my wrist. It is quite a light watch, although it's on the bigger side. Even though it's a 44 millimeter watch, you can see I have absolutely no problem wearing this watch. If you're interested in buying this watch, you can use the code WATCHON15, then you will get 15% discount. This watch is priced at $350. So if you use the discount code, you can actually get this watch for $280, and AVI-8 watches have free shipping worldwide. So to conclude the review, I think this watch is very much a design watch. It's very much a history watch. But I think they actually managed to get some really nice quality into this watch. And to think this watch is under $300, I think you get real value. My criticism is that it's kind of a polarizing watch because it is very much a loud and masculine design. It's on the bigger side, so you definitely need to have the kind of tendency towards more pronounced masculine loud watches. This is definitely no dress watch. It's not an anonymous watch in no sense whatsoever. Of course, the movement is kind of a standard movement. It's a good movement, but you get a little bit bored with these NH35A movements in all watches. I also don't know how the case will actually age in time. Will you actually scratch off this layering, or will it just stay on? But you buy a watch for less than $300, it's also all about just enjoying this watch in the moment. I can definitely also understand if people think this watch isn't too legible on the first glance, because you get these dark skeletonized hands, as you can see, except for the second hand, which is blue. So at the glance, just looking at your wrist, it might be a little hard to actually read the time. I hope you enjoyed the full review. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Instagram and Facebook. Don't forget to visit AVI-8 Watches. You can find the link down in the description. You get 15% of everything you buy on AVI-8 Watches website if you use the code WATCHON15. Thank you. Bye.